Hello and welcome. Let's find the antiderivative, or the integral, of tan x. This is another one of those integrals that has quite a counterintuitive result, and to do it we have to use a little bit of lateral thinking. And what I mean by that is we're going to get a result that really doesn't resemble the original function. And I can remember when I was first studying calculus that these always had me confused. So let's try and make some sense out of it. To carry out this integral is actually not that hard, but we do have to realize that tan of x is equal to the sine of x divided by the cos of x. So that implies we're going to be integrating the quotient of the sine of x over the cos of x dx. This sine x term up here is the key to determining how we integrate this. The sine x is very closely related to the derivative of cos x. In fact, if I choose to write it like this, minus the negative of sine x and I bring out one of the negatives to the front, negative of minus sine x divided by cos x . What I have now is the derivative of the bottom function, the denominator function, on the top. And that means I can just do a simple u-substitution here, because this negative sine x term is going to cancel out once I transform the independent variable, the x, into another function, another variable, u. So let's do that. So let u equal cos x, then du dx is equal to negative sine x, so the derivative of cos x, or the differential of cos x. And if I rearrange this du dx to get dx as the subject, I'll get du divided by negative sine x, and I can write that as negative of du on sine x. Okay, so the negative of the integral of negative sine x divided by cos x with respect to x is now negative of negative sine x divided by u times 1 on sine x, negative of 1 on sine x du. These negative sine x's cancel out, and I will just get negative of du on u, which we know the result as negative of the natural log of u, natural log of the absolute value of u, I should say, plus an integration constant c. And if I was to substitute u for cos x back in, I shall get negative ln cos x, the absolute value of cos x, plus c. I can also write this using my log laws as ln of the absolute value of cos x to the negative 1 which is equal to ln of 1 divided by cos x. And that's equal to ln of sec x. So perhaps a little neater way of writing it without the negative in the front, but essentially these two are the same thing. And that is the integral of tan x done. Please give me a like if you found this video useful. If you are currently studying math, please feel free to subscribe to my channel for future videos that may help you on exams or assignments. And as always, please feel free to ask me any question by commenting on any of the videos that you've seen. Thanks for watching, and I hope you've learned something.